So good day everyone. So we're going to discuss mycology and virology today. So under microbiology yung reporting ng group namin. So this is the topic layout. I'm going to discuss introduction to mycology, tapos systemic mycosis and superficial mycosis. So, mycology is the study of fungi. So, there are more than 50,000 species of fungi. However, there are only 100 to 150 that are pathogenic to humans. So, basically, fungi are eukaryotes. So, it means that there's a membrane-bound nucleus dun sa cell ng mga fungi. So, ang fungi can be multicellular or unicellular, depende na lang kung ano yung form nila. So, kapag molds and mushrooms, they are multicellular. However, kapag yeasts yung fungi, they are considered as unicellular. There are also saprophytes, which means they acquire nutrients from organic substances through chemical processes, and they also get their nutrition from decaying substances or organisms. So they are heterotrophic. So this means that they cannot manufacture their own food. So, madaming nagsasabi if plant ba yung fungi, or madaming nagtatanong if more like plants ba ang fungi or more like animals. So, based dun sa nahanap ko kasing source, sinasabi na more like animals ang fungi kasi hindi nila kayang mag-manufacture ng sarili nilang food. So, basically, nag-a-acquire sila ng food or nutrients from other sources, like yung mga decaying matter or decaying substances or what. So they are considered as aerobes or facultative anaerobes. So basically, ang ibig sabihin na to, majority ng mga fungi ay kailangan ng oxygen para mabuhay. So yung aerobes means that they need oxygen. Facultative anaerobes, so basically, aerobic din sila, pero pwede silang mabuhay sa mga environment that lacks oxygen. So, yung facultative anaerobes, pwede yun both ways. So, in terms of reproduction, they can reproduce asexually or sexually. So, by means of asexual reproduction, it can either be fragmentation, budding, or producing spores. Or sexually, in terms of mating between two haploid hyphae. So, sa reproduction, we will discuss more of that later. So, as I mentioned earlier, fungi are not considered as plants. They also lack chlorophyll. Chlorophyll, yun yung green pigment ng plants that is required kapag nagko-collect sila ng sunlight. So, we're going to discuss the structures. So, ito yung mga major structures ng fungi. So, yung talus, yung body. As you can see in the illustration, ito yung talus, yung fruiting body nila. So, ito yung madalas na nakikita or yung majority ng part ng fungi na visible. So, ang next, yung hyphae. So, ito yung branching filaments of the talus. So, ito yung parang content ng talus or yung mga nasa loob ng talus. So, they can be septate or aseptate. So yung septate kasi divided by cross walls. So ayun, divided by, so meron siyang partition. Yung aseptate or coenocytic, ito yung mga walang division. So ang hyphae kapag nagmass yan, or which means yung kapag meron na yung web-like structure or yung pagka nag-overlap na sila sa isa't isa, ang tinatawag doon ay mycelium. So ito na yung parang network of hyphae, kumbaga, making up the colony of a fungus. So it is also important to note that fungi has chitin and ergosterol. So ito yung very important component ng cell wall nila para to ensure the integrity and yung stability ng fungi. So chitin is a long carbohydrate polymer which adds rigidity and structural support to the cell wall of the fungus. And ergosterol is the most abundant sterol in fungal cell membrane. So ito yung nagre-regulate ng permeability and fluidity. So permeability, it means that yung mga nagpa-pass through na nutrients, siya yung nag-a-allow nun kapag may kailangan pumasok dun sa may kailangan na nutrients yung fungi. So we're going to discuss also the fungal life cycle. So this is basically the life cycle of the fungi. So as you can see, medyo complex siya kung susumahin. Kasi ang fungi is capable, some fungi are capable of asexual and sexual reproduction. Depende na lang yan kung ano yung classification nila. So, ang start niyan, so yung mycelium, magpro-produce ng spore-producing structures or yung mga conidia, yung mga ganon. Once na nag-produce yun, it will turn into spores. Tapos, mag-germinate yung spores na yun. Once na nag-germinate yun, lumago or nag-grow, magpo-form siya ng mycelium. So, itong mycelium is capable also of sexual reproduction. So once na nag-mycelium siya, so capable siya na mag-plasmogamy or fusion of cytoplasm. Ito yung mag-merge yung nucleus ng ng mycelium. Tapos magkakaroon ng addition ng parang mag-meet yung ano yung dalawang nucleus which then will result to karyogamy. So yung parent na nucleus yan na yung magiging fusion nila. Magpo-form ng fusion. Tapos ito na yung karyogamy. Once na nag-undergo na ng karyogamy, magiging diploid na sila. Once na naging diploid, they will undergo meiosis or yung process ng reproduction na meiosis. So, once na nag-undergo na ng meiosis, so maproproduce na yung spore-producing structures. So, ito yung ano, yung parang asexual phase din, asexual reproduction din na discuss kanina. Once na nag produce na ng spores, so mag-germinate siya. Once na nag-grow na ulit or nag-network, mag-form siya into mycelium. So continuous process lang siya. So parang sexual reproduction is a combination of sexual and asexual basically. Kasi meron din siyang part na asexual kasi may release din ng spores. So, ayun. So, ito yung sporulation. Ito yung iba't ibang kinds ng spores. So, ito yung first natin i-discuss. Asexual spore. So, sporangiospore, the first type of asexual spore. is formed by an internal cleavage of the contents of a sporangium, a sac that is like, that is supported by a sporangiophore. So, ito yung itsura niya. Ito yung sporangiophore. So, ito yung sporangium. So, as you can see, nandito yung mga spores niya. So, nagre-reproduce to by release of spores. So, the next one is the conidiophore. Sporangiospore din siya. However, there's no membrane, as you can see. Para siyang grapes. So, ito yung beaded structure niya. Ito yung spores. So, ganyan yung structure niya. Tapos, yung parang stem-like structure niya is known as conidiophore. So, ang conidiospore, nahahati din siya sa dalawa. So, it can either be blastospores or these are produced by budding or atrospore. It is formed by the breaking up or disarticulation. So, ito yung mga na-mention ko kanina na iba't ibang ways ng asexual reproduction. So, the next one is the chlamydiospore. So, formed by rounding off a cell or cells. So, makikita natin sa illustration. So, parang ano siya? Parang bamboo yung itsura niya. So, kapag nasa may dulong part, it is known as terminal. Tapos, kapag nasa middle, it is known as intercalary. Tapos, kapag yung structure niya is what do you call this? Magkasunod or parallel to each other, it is known as sessile. Ito naman yung na sexual spore. So zygospore is formed by fusion of two compatible hyphal arms and they're surrounded by a thick wall. So there's a protective wall called the zygosporangium. So this type of spore produces sporangiospores and zygospores. So capable siya ng two kinds of spores. So, yung sporangiospores, as I mentioned earlier, is considered as asexual. Diba na-mention ko kanina na yung sexual reproduction is capable of sexual and asexual phase. So, ayun. So, capable siya ng dalawang kinds of spores. So, the next one is ascospore. So, it is a spore formed in sac-like cells known as ascus. So, it often have 8 spores na na-form. So, ang na-produce niya is ascospore and frequently conidiospore. Conidiospore is asexual din. Asexual spore din siya. So, as you can see, parang ano siya? Parang may familiar na plant yung itsura niya. So, parang, what do you call that? I forgot. So, ascus. So, basically, yung ascus yung term sa bone structure. Tapos, yung ascospore, yung mga nasa loob. So, the next one is the basidiospore. It is a sexual spore that protrude out of a mother cell called basidium. So, it produces basidiospores and sometimes conidiospores. So, makikita natin sa illustration, ito yung basidium or yung mother cell. So, protrude means yung parang lumalabas or nagse-separate or umaalis dun sa mismong pinanggalingan niya. So, nagpro-protrude. So, as you can see, parang medyo attached pa siya. So, ayun. Protrusion ng sexual spore. So, ito yung basidiospore spore nila. So, we'll be discussing also the stages of fungi. So, there are two types of stage. So, it can either be anamorph or teleomorph. So, anamorph, yung asexual stage nila. So, meron tayong tinatawag na anamorphic fungi, which are Penicillium, Sporotrix, and Candida albicans. So, ito lang yung mga medyo familiar ako, kaya na-include ko. Pero madami pa siyang iba. So, teleomorph, on the other hand, is a sexual stage. So, ang term nito kapag yung fungi ay teleomorphic fungi. So, lastly, holomorph refers to the entire fungus. So, it includes both amorph and teleomorph. So, ito yung parang general term kapag it undergoes anamorph and teleomorph. So, ito yung as a whole, kumbaga. So, it is also important to know that fungi reproduces via asexual reproduction. So, generally. So, majority ng fungi reproduces through asexual reproduction. So, as I mentioned earlier, kahit yung sexual reproduction ng fungi, nag-undergo pa din ng asexual. So, ayun. Additional info lang din. So, these are the classification of fungi. So, as you can see, under clinical classification, it is divided into 5. So, superficial, cutaneous, subcutaneous, systemic, and opportunistic. So, itong clinical na to, we're going to discuss that further in the following presentations or slides. So, I'll be discussing superficial and systemic. So, the other kinds will be discussed by my groupmates. So, just to give you a brief info about this is superficial or cosmetic fungal infections of the skin or shaft. So, usually, ito yung mga located sa may outer part ng skin natin. So, ito yung mga corpus na nadi-discuss natin. So, dun sila na-locate. So, superficial. So, yan. Cutaneous. So, they are considered as the fungal infection of the skin, hair, and nails. So, cutaneous, from the word cutaneous. So, skin, hair, and nails siya. So, subcutaneous naman, group of fungi that infects the skin. So, yung more on subcutaneous tissue na siya. So, which means, mas deeper na yung nai-infect niya. So, it can also, on some cases, infect underlying tissues and organs. So, ganun na siya. Kaya niya mag-propagate sa more deeper parts ng skin. Tapos, pwede din siya mag-penetrate sa mga tissues and organs natin. So, systemic mycosis. So, ito yung mga infection na nag-a-affect ng internal organs or deep tissues of the body. So, most well-known na systemic response kapag merong infection nito ay fever. So, ito yung talagang medyo deadly na kasi buong system na natin yung affected. So, multiple organs na yung pwede niyang ma-infect. So, the next one is opportunistic. So, ito yung mga fungi that causes infection to immunocompromised individuals. So, immunocompromised, yan yung term kapag mahina na yung immune system or may condition or underlying condition yung patient. Tapos, mahina na talaga yung immune system niya. Kaya, prone siya sa mga opportunistic fungi. Kasi yung opportunistic, hindi, on a healthy individual, hindi niya kaya magpakita ng mga ng sakit, kumbaga. So, yung mga infectious symptoms niya, eh, more like nagpapakita lang kapag mahina na talaga or weakened yung immune system. So, the other type of classification is known as taxonomical, or ito yung ano, division ng fungi depende sa itsura niya or structure niya. So, these are zygomycota, basidiomycota, ascomycota, and uteromycota. So, zygomycota is also known as zygote fungi. Basidiomycota is known as filamentous fungi. Ascomycota is also known as sac fungi. Uteromycota is known as the imperfect fungi kasi yung structure niya medyo unusual. So, it's known as imperfect fungi. So, ang important na madi-discuss is yung morphological classification. So, it is classified into three. So, yeast, molds, and dimorphic fungi. So, we will discuss this further. So, ito yung yeast. So, 2 to 60 micrometers yung size niya. It is usually round to oval in shape. So, ito yung considered as unicellular organism. So, it grows at 37 degrees Celsius. This means that ang yeast, most likely pathogenic siya sa human body kasi as you can see, 37 degrees Celsius, ito yung normal temperature ng body. So, optimal siya sa growth ng yeast. So, most probably, maganda mag-grow ang yeast sa katawan. Kaya, mabilis siyang dumami. So, in terms of reproduction, it can reproduce asexually and sexually. So, asexually, classified siya into two, or divided siya into two, budding and binary fission. So, budding is classified into two then. It is through germ tube, or these are small projections, or pseudohyphae. Pseudohyphae is a chain of elongated budding cells. So, parang pinahaba siyang budding cells na hindi na di-divide or na hahati. So, the next one is binary fission. So, binary fission, na-encounter natin ito sa bacteria also. So, binary fission from one cell, bigla na lang siyang mag-undergo ng process para maging two. So, magdi-divide siya. So, ayun. So, sexually, it produces ascospore and basidiospore. So, the next one is molds. So, these are multicellular organisms unlike yung yeast earlier. So, grows at 25 degrees Celsius. So, optimal temperature niya is 25 degrees Celsius. So, this means na more like nag-grow siya sa mga room temp. So, possible siya mag grow sa mga objects or yung mga food, mga ganon. Kaya yung bread natin nagkakaroon ng molds kasi it is capable of growing at room temp. So, ang hyphae, ang molds, meron siyang iba't ibang hyphae. Depende sa sa use nito. So meron siyang vegetative hyphae. So it comprises the body of the fungus and the reproductive hyphae. So ito yung supports reproductive structures like conidia. So there are also types of hyphae like coenocytic. So ito yung mga no division or non-septate. Hyaline, these are septate and non-pigmented hyphae. Non-pigmented means wala siyang color. So, or lax color siya. So, dematiaceous type of hyphae is dark and pigmented septate hyphae. So, meron din siyang division. So, dark and pigmented din siya. Dark and pigmented siya, unlike yung hyaline. So, yung mycelium, meron din siyang iba't iba. Vegetative. So it is the nutrient absorbing and water exchanging portion of the fungus. Aerial, so ito yung mga capable of growing or existing in the air. So yung fertile naman, so ito yung mga merong conidia for reproduction, fertile. So it is responsible for fertilization or reproduction ng mycelium. So, ito yung third type, dimorphic fungi. So, dimorphic kasi it can exhibit either yeast or mold phase. So, usually, it is thermally dimorphic. So, this means na depende sa temperature, mag-change siya ng phase. So, kapag yung fungi nasa 22 to 25 degrees. So, ito yung parang mold phase niya. So, ito yung meron siyang hyphal or mycelial form like yung mold. So, kapag yung 37 degrees Celsius, ito yung yeast phase niya. Kasi, di ba, as I mentioned earlier, ang yeast nagro-grow siya at an optimal temperature of 37 degrees Celsius. So, these are some of the medically important dimorphic fungi. So like Histoplasma, Capsulatum, Blastomyces, Dermatitis, Parococcyx, Diodes brasiliensis, Coccidoides imitis. So majority ng mga na-mention ko ay systemic mycosis siya. So we'll discuss that further later. So, ito na, systemic mycosis. So, these are infections that affects the internal organs or deep tissues of the body. So, ito yung mga nagkakos ng infection sa mga organs natin or deep tissues. So, the initial site of infection is the lung. So, this means that ang mode of transmission ng majority ng mga fungi na classified as systemic is through inhalation. So, inhalation siya. Kasi ang site of infection is the lungs. So, ang generalized symptoms niya ay fever, fatigue, or pagkapagod, chronic cough, and chest pain. Yun yung mga possible na maging symptoms kapag meron itong infection. So, ito na yung different fungi na classified into systemic mycosis. So, hindi na natin masyadong i-discuss. Briefly na lang yung pagtakel natin dito kasi medyo madami siya in table form na din para mas madali siyang intindihin. Histoplasma capsulatum or other known as Agelomyces capsulatus. So Agelomyces is term for I think the sexual phase of the the fungi, kaya tinerm siya as agelomyces. So, ang name of infection niya is histoplasmosis. So, from the name itself, histoplasmosis. So, ang MOT niya or method of transmission or mode of transmission is inhalation of infectious elements. So, ang source niya, soil. So, yung soil na yun is often associated with decaying bat guano or bird droppings. So, yung mga droppings ng birds or bats or yung fecal matter nila or fecal substances, once na nag-ano yun sa soil, tapos na-inhale ng tao, possible na makuha tong fungi na to. So, ang distinct feature niya, so at body temp, the organism is a budding yeast found predominantly in histiocytes. So, histiocytes, I think, is macrophage or an APC, antigen-presenting cells. So, ayan. So, ang treatment niya is amphotericin B. So, ito yung for disseminated infection. And itraconazole for immunocompromised patients. So, the next one is Blastomyces dermatitidis. It is also known as Agelomyces dermatitidis. So, I think it's also the same with histoplasma. It is coined, I think it's the sexual phase of the fungi. So, ang name of infection niya is blastomycosis. Mode of transmission niya is inhalation of the spores or the microconidia. So, I think the source din nito is soil din. Kasi often sa mga systemic is nakukuha sa soil. So, buds are produced singly and are attached to parent cell by broad base. So, parang in pairs yung itsura niya kapag microscopic view. Kaya, yun yung distinct feature niya. So, ang treatment niya ay amphotericin B din. Amphotericin B, but yung results niya medyo hindi consistent. So, next one is the 2-hydroxystilbamidine. The next one is ketoconazole para less nephrotoxicity or para hindi masyadong toxic sa kidneys natin. So, the next one is the coccidioides imitis. It is also known as valley fever fungus. Valley fever fungus kasi meron yung certain valley na location located sa isang place na dun common yung coccidioides imitis. Kaya naging term siya as valley fever fungus. Yung name of infection niya, coccidioidomycosis. Tapos yung mode of transmission niya is inhalation din of spores. So, ang source niya, it is in lower Sonoran life zone or ito yung mga dry places like, I think, savanna and semi-arid conditions. So, as you can see, as indicated in this presentation, common din siya sa mga loose desert soil. So, kaya usual to sa mga drylands. So ang distinct feature niya, ito yung considered as most virulent mycotic agent. So ito yung pinaka-deadly kumbaga. So the treatment is amphotericin B. So ito yung drug of choice. However, there are also trials for itraconazole and fluconazole. So, medyo okay-okay din yung results. So the next one is Paracoccidioides brasiliensis. So yung other name niya hindi ko mahanap, so not applicable. So name of infection is paracoccidioidomycosis. So mode of transmission niya is inhalation din. So common siya sa mga acidic soil. So ito yung mga high rainfall area. So maulan yung area kung saan siya nag commonly found. So it requires increased humidity. So ang distinct feature niya has no typical sporulation and it also have a Mickey Mouse cap appearance kapag microscopic. So ang treatment niya is amphotericin B and itraconazole. The next one is Tularemiasis marnefi or marnefi. So ang old name niya is Penicillium marnefi. So name of infection is Tularemiasis. Mode of transmission is inhalation of conidia. So ang source nito ay bamboo rat. So and the Vietnamese bamboo rat. So may mga studies daw na nagsasabi na yung fungi daw nito ay present din sa mga wound or sa skin ng bamboo rat and Vietnamese bamboo rat. However, yung mode of transmission niya, based dun sa nabasa ko, medyo hindi pa accurate. Pero meron ako nahanap na inhalation of conidia daw yung MOT niya. So, an emerging dimorphic pathogenic fungus endemic to Southeast Asia. So it is the only pathogenic form the only pathogenic from Penicillium species. So ang treatment niya is amphotericin B and itraconazole din. So lastly, is the Cryptococcus neoformans. Old name niya is Torula histolytica. So name of infection is Cryptococcosis. So yan. And mode of transmission niya is inhalation of spores. So common ito sa mga pigeons. So avian excreta or yung droppings ng pigeons. Common din siya sa mga sites kung yung mga kulungan ng pigeons. Particular din sa mga roosts and droppings niya. So ang distinct feature niya is monomorphic siya and is always in yeast form. So kahit 25 or 37 degrees Celsius yung environment, it maintains the yeast form. So, also, the yeast has an acidic mucopolysaccharide capsule. So, yun yung very distinct feature niya. So, ang treatment is amphotericin B and in combination with 5-fluorocytosine and pwede din yung fluconazole. So, next. So, ito yung superficial mycosis. As I mentioned earlier. So, limited lang sila sa outermost part layer ng skin or hair with little tissue damage and generally no inflammatory response. So, since nasa outermost part na sila, hindi sila nag-trigger ng immune response. And madalas kapag hindi masyadong grabe yung infection or ng superficial mycosis, hindi din mamamalayan ng individual na meron na siya nito. So, these are cosmetic fungal infections of the skin or shaft. So, no living tissues is invaded and there is no cellular response from the host. Essentially, no pathological changes are elicited. So, ito yung based dun sa na-search ko. Ito yung four species under superficial mycosis. Madami pa yatang iba, pero ito yung most common. So, the first one is Malassezia furfur. Ang other name niya is Pityrosporum ovale. I think this is yung previous name niya. So, name of infection is Tinea versicolor or Pityriasis versicolor. Mode of transmission is direct contact. So, since nasa skin nga, outer part nga sila ng skin, most common transmission is through direct contact. So, source ng nito is common in humid, hot and tropical places. So, high prevalence in corticosteroid therapy patients. So, basically, it is a part of normal flora and cause endogenous infection or autoinfection. So, based dun sa nabasa ko, meron ding genetic factor itong certain species na to. And possible na dumami siya through profuse sweating. So kapag pawisin yung tao, mas higher yung risk na magkaroon siya nito or mag-overgrow yung species na to. So ang treatment nito, removal of the organism from the skin, topical preparations containing myconazole nitrate, or kapag sa mga hair, treatment with anti-dandruff shampoos. The next one is Horteia wernicke, also no, previously known as Cladosporium wernicke. The name of infection is Tinea nigra. So, mode of transmission, direct inoculation or direct contact. So, direct contact sa skin or injury or part na injured na skin. So, ang source niya is soil, wood, and decaying vegetation. So, ang distinct feature niya is brown to black non-scaly macules that occur most often on the palms of the hands and soles of the feet. So, the fungus is melanin producing. So, melanin, we all know melanin is capable of producing brown to black color. I think most common kapag brown. So it is called dematiceous fungus. So, ang treatment niya is keratolytic agents. So, tincture of iodine, 2% salicylic acid, 3% sulfuric acid, or Whitfield's ointment. So, the next one is Trichosporon asahi. So, based sa nabasa ko kasi, meron yung iba't ibang Trichosporon species na capable of causing infection known as white piedra. Pero ang pinaka-common or clinically significant is the Trichosporon asahi. So, yun yung pinili kong i-discuss today. So, it is previously known as Trichosporum bagelli. So, name of infection, white piedra. Mode of transmission niya. So, meron na nabasa kasi na hindi pa masyadong known yung mode of transmission niya. Pero, transmitted siya from person to person by infected hair on shared combs or hairbrushes. So, may possibility din na meron din ako nabasa na possible din daw na STD or sexually transmitted yung Trichosporon kasi yung kapag yung sa pubic hair nung infected individual, possible na mahawa yung partner. So ang source niya is soil, lake waters, and plants. So ang distinct feature niya, kasi meron siyang in comparison, which is the black piedra. So ang distinct feature niya is nodular infection of hair shaft. So most commonly sa scalp, axillary, beard, and pubic hairs, as I mentioned earlier. And it is characterized by soft white to light brown nodules, which is formed around the hair shaft. So, ang treatment niya is shaving or cutting the infected hair, topical fungicides such as bichloride of mercury, benzoic and salicylic acid combinations, 3% sulfur ointments, and 2% formalin. So lastly, Piedre Hortei, or P. Hortei. Wala kasi ang mahanap na other name niya. So name of infection is Black Piedra. So method of transmission niya is person to person then by infected hair on shared combs or hair brushes. Source niya is soils of tropical and subtropical environments. So distinct features niya, nodular infections of scalp hair and characterized by hard. So compared dun sa white piedra, scalp hair siya and is characterized by hard brown to black nodules attached to hair shaft. So, ang treatment niya, shaving and cutting the infected hair, use of topical fungicides, bichloride of mercury, benzoic acid, salicylic acid combination. So, ayan. That's all for my presentation. I hope you learned something. And the other topics will be discussed further by my groupmates, and thank you very much for listening, and God bless.